Check, check.
Trailer back behind the main grandstand area. Riley Hickman and Mark Fields, front row, side by side, nose to tail out of turn four, coming up. Keep your eyes on them, race fans. We're coming to green. First heat race of the Ground Pounders, set ready to come off turn number four. Eyes on them, race fans. Here we go. Hickman and Fields. Green is out down the main straightaway. Riley's going to hot foot it into turn one. Here comes Coach David Payne, three wide back through the field. Riley Hickman, then it's Mark Fields, then it's David Payne, then it's Ryan King. Just putting them up in the wall. Here we go. Lap one in the books. Riley Hickman showing away early on. Putting them side by side with Ryan in 30. They duke it out for position four. Two down, eight to go. So Fields in the 26F, he's second. Coach David Payne in third. David Payne, a regular on the series. Then it's Ryan King, then it's Josh Putnam. Behind him, Josh Collins. Probably going to have those guys looking at a provisional. Ryan Delph will have that for us later on. So up front, Riley Hickman, current Southern All-Star Series points leader, defending Southern Regional Series champion in R1 out front. Next time by, it'll be five down, five to go. Riley Hickman in it, Masters build, sponsored by American Billet, Hickman Manufacturing entry. Mark Fields from Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, and the NEA car coach David Payne out of Murphy, North Carolina. Your top three, they go to the show. The rest transfer to the trailer. Positions four and five go to the scramble. The Delph Communications scramble coming up after these races here tonight, the four heats. It'll be three to go for Riley Hickman in R1. Tell you what, they're getting down close to the qualifying times, I believe. Two laps remain in this first qualifying heat here tonight. Riley Hickman showing away early. Overall fast qualifier tonight was Ryan Gifford in that 41 Team Dillon Racing entry. So Riley Hickman gonna go on here. Final time down the back straightaway, checkered flag. He's gonna win heat number one. Second is Mark Fields in 26F. Mark Fields second. Third's Coach David Payne. Fourth, Ryan King. And fifth, Josh Putnam. So David Payne third, Mark Fields second, and your winner in R1 out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, the American Billet Hickman Manufacturing VP Fuels. Hickson sponsored Masters Build out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. Put your hands together for Riley Hickman in Cotterbur R1 Spring Nationals and two touring provisionals. So that emergency provisionals used for drivers trying to pick up points and only money that they get advancing from start money. So if they advance, they only receive that amount, not the start money, just the amount that they advance. 10 laps, 8 cars, top 3 go. Scott Cook out of Shelbyville, Caleb Ashby out of Cunningham. Eyes on him out of 4, green flag in the air. Here we go. Heat number 2, Ashby on that outside. Billy Ogle getting loose off air off of turn number 2. Ames and them go around them. Ogle trying to get in, not have to use a provisional here tonight. Ogle, a couple East Tennessee cars battling it out. Billy Ogle Jr. in 201, Welsh in 29, out of Maryville, Tennessee. They'll battle it out. Welsh, the defending track champion at Cleveland Speedway. Ogle, a 2011 Southern All-Star Series champion, and currently second, 30 points behind Orange Crush Deep Case Molded Series points. Ashby up front, the 61 out of Cunningham, Tennessee. Second is Scott Cook out of Shelbyville. And here comes Billy the Kid in 201. Trying to take that third spot from the 29 of Jason Welshin. Ogle with a move out of 2. Here he goes. Puts that Blunt Motorsports rocket chassis nose to the inside of Welshin. Nuking it off door to door for 4. Best battle on the speedway. 5 down, 5 to go. Ogle back there. Vic Hill behind him. Wow. Good cars going to the scramble here in a little bit. Eight cars will make up the Dells Communication scramble as the laps start to wind down in this one, folks. It'll be two to go this time for the 61 out of Cunningham, Tennessee. Caleb Ashby, two laps remain. Can he win the second qualifying heat race? White flag in the air, final time there. Checkered flag will come out for the 61. Scott Cook second, Jason Welsh in third. Wow, good race in that one. Finishing 30, transfers the 29 out of Maryville, Tennessee. Good on the field, 10 laps, top three go in this one. Heat four coming up next. So Mashburn out of provincials, he's got to get in through the heat race. Green is out, here we go. Yellow light coming on. I believe they got a little gun shy down there in turn number four. We'll give that a quick diagnosis of premature acceleration. He has to get in through tonight's heat race if he wants to go to the show or through the scramble. We'll try it again out of four. Mashburn and Terry English, the veteran, out of Benton, Kentucky. Green is out. Here we go. Terry English leads George Mashburn and Dylan White. See if Tim Fuller can come in. He's knocked off a couple cars so far. Trying to at least get into the scramble event later on. Tim Fuller, the Empire Executioner out of Watertown, New York, at a Capital Race Cars entry tonight. Terry English up front, George Mashburn, Dylan White. Then it's the 16 entry of Daniel Miller out of Shelbyville, Tennessee. Battling it out for that third spot. He wants it. White going high side. Here's Case Bolt behind him. Only three go to the show. We're lap four this time. Case Bolt on that outside line, trying to look in. Case Bolt not wanting to have to come out of the scramble or take a series provisional tonight. Terry English, the 96, the veteran 50-year-old out of Benton, Kentucky up front. Then it's George Mashburn, Daniel Miller. Then behind him, it's Dylan White and Steve Casebolt in C9. Lap started to wind down in this one, folks. Three remain. It'll be two at the stripe next time. English setting sail in this one. Miller seeing if he can get around for George Mashburn and advance his feature starting position here tonight. He won second from the 13 Mastersville from Murphy, North Carolina, second in that one. And we got a car slowed in two. He's back on the gas, Chad Winkles. Case Bolt slows in three, white flag in the air. We'll see if we can have our first caution of the race. Oh, what's gonna happen? Case Bolt keeps moving. Terry English out of four. It's gonna be Terry English taking a win here in heat number three. Second is George Mashburn. Third is Daniel Miller. Wow, Case Bolt come to a stop at the top of turn number four. Track was not blocked. We came back to the checkered flag. Wow, what a race for Terry English. Top three go. Murfreesboro, Tennessee, it's David Earl Gentry. Not normally in the 56 tonight, he's in the 11. Alongside him out of Weston, Ohio, it is Rusty Schlenk. You can find him on Saturday nights at Oakshade in Ohio. Row three, it's Victor Lee in four, the Revolution race car, the Kevin Eisen-owned entry out of Danville, Kentucky. Joe Denby in 27, Cale Finley 36, 10 is Wesley Shelton. Kevin LeBourne is 28K, here we go, 10 laps, top three go to the show. Denby, looks like he gets messed up there on the front straightaway. Everybody keeps going. Rusty Slink slows at the top of two. Yellow is out. Out here, we'll try it again. Brinkley and Kinzer, much better start that time. Kinzer will lead them into one. Kinzer up the point, down the back straightaway. Brinkley to the inside for the lead. Kinzer, Brinkley, Rusty Schlink. Rusty, been a long time since he's been here to Duck River Raceway Park. Battle down the back straightaway for the lead. Brinkley wants it from Kinzer, side by side out of four. It's a dogfight into one. Best race of the night so far. Brinkley to the inside, he's got it out of two down the back straightaway. Jay Brinkley takes the lead in 10. Kinzer second, here comes Rusty Schlink. Be five down, five to go next time. Kinzer a little bit squirrely up on the top side, allowing Schlink to get down low. Here comes David Earl Gentry in 11, fourth spot. Five down, five to go. Final qualifying heat of the night. Brinkley out in front in this one. Problems for the K-28 machine. Kevin LeBourne out of Shelbyville, Tennessee, bringing out another yellow flag as he slows going into one. Will be two to go. Brinkley pulling out with a good lead there. Looks like a left rear flat. Cars that's left down in the infield for the scramble race. The Delph Communications scramble four laps. Drivers that were in. Fourth and fifth that did not transfer earlier. We'll be making up that. Brinkley to the point, here we go. Eyes on him out of four. Oh man, they get crossed up down the main straightaway. Something, a problem maybe on Kinzer's car. Didn't obviously something happen, he couldn't go there. Not sure what the problem was. And Brandon Kinzer pulls into the pit area. Oh, man. Rusty Schlink making that long journey from Ohio worth it. Trying to win this one. Look at the 36 car. Cale Finley started seventh, he's third. Jay Brinkley trying to go on to win this one. Dogfight, it's Brinkley. Second is Schlink. Third is the 36 car of Cale Finley. Wow, what a show. Your winner in car number 10, the driver to Shelbyville, Tennessee. Put your hands together for Jay Brinkley. And this is just the heats, folks. Seven cars will duke it out for one position. The winner starts 23rd. Just the winner goes, so it's going to be a dogfight. Four-lap scramble. Ryan King. Vic Hill. Eyes on him out of four. Here we go. Who's it going to be? For the final spot of tonight's feature event, Ryan King out of Seymour leads him into turn number three. Vic Hill on the outside. Can Vic Hill make it in? Dylan Ames, Dylan White, Josh Putnam, Joe Denby. So Ryan King out front, white flag in the air, final time. So Ryan King trying to get in. This was his only shot. He'll do it, it's start 23rd. Ryan King out of Seymour, Tennessee's in the show. Second to Vic Hill, third to Dylan Ames, fourth to Dylan White, but only the winner goes, and it was a dogfight. All right, race fans, here we go. Duck River Raceway Park. Everybody up, folks. Let's go. Need everybody on your feet. So let's send them off spring national style. Come on, everybody up, folks. Four wide, 24 of the best in the Southeast. Going to duke it out for you here tonight at Duck River Raceway Park. As they'll be coming four wide, salute to you. They'll be waving at you. Send them off here down the main straightaway. Four wide, Spring Nationals. Down the main straightaway. One previous winner in the field, Dale McDowell, our inaugural Spring Nationals winner. He starts in fourth. His teammate starting on the pole. Be showing him one to go at the line this time by 40 laps the distance. Who's it gonna be? What about Tim McCready? He starts in third. He was a podium finish here at the World of Outlaws a few weeks ago that Eric Wells won. Eyes on him out of turn number four. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is showtime. Green flag is out down the main straightaway. Capital Clint gonna take the lead down the back chute. Ryan Gifford second, Dale McDowell, Tim McCready, Stacy Bowles in fifth. They get strung out back through the field, one lap in the books. Wow, we got a lap in. Shane Clint down front running, cars get bunched in behind him. Fast paced laps here at Duck River Raceway Park. Out front with three down. A lot of laps to go. We had a caution-free feature in our second race of the season, but we have that here tonight. Be nice to see 40 green flag laps. A scorer's nightmare. Car through the infield. George Mashburn. Clanton, Gifford, McDowell, and McCready. Out of there comes McDowell and his teammate for second. And three wide back there for second, coming off of four. T-Mac on the back bumper of McDowell. Gifford drifts up the racetrack. We'll leave a lapper between first and second for McCready on his back bumper for third. Capital Clanton leads him, the Georgia Bulldog. Then it's Dale McDowell. Then it's Tim McCready. A Masters built a warrior. They start to work lap traffic. Oh, Clanton almost gets into the back of the lap car, 30 Ryan King. And they get caught behind him. Here comes Dale McDowell to the outside. He'll take the point out of two down the back straightaway. Nope. McCready's going to go around him. Plant still out front. McCready, then McDowell, then Gifford, then Stacy Bowles, the top five. We got a comes T-Mac, Tim McCready. Tim McCready on the back bumper. pair of World Outlaw regulars, first and second. Side by side off of two. 11 laps in the books. McCready getting trapped behind the 36 car of Cale Finley, a lap car. And the yellow is out. Yellow is out. They got a car stop at the top of turn four. Our first yellow flag. It's Steve Casebolt. Pulls off in turn number four. First yellow flag of the evening here on, which I like in competition for Spring National Series. Shane Clanton. And look who's behind him right on his back bumper now. No lap cars in between him. T-Mac in second. Green is out. Here we go. Sixth place there, Mike Chilton. Good run for the series regular so far in this one. Behind another series regular, Stacy Bowles. Eight cars have traveled to all the series events so far. T-Mac giving him all he wants. T-Mac trying to get around Shane Clanton for that top spot. The Sweeteners Plus Warrior chassis working on the Kennedy Motorsports Capital entry. Parawu regulars side by side. Too close to call at the line, lap 15. Close to halfway in this one, folks. Side by side for the race lead, we got a car. Back straightaway is blocked. All right, guys, we're showing them one to go. So your new leader here on lap 16, just shy of the halfway point. T-Mac, Tim McCready, then it's Mac Daddy Dale McDowell, Ryan Gifford, Stacy Bowles, and a top five for the Revolution race car entry of Michael Chilton out of Kentucky. Green is out. Here we go. Stacy Bowles trying to go for third spot from Ryan Gifford, side by side out of four. Give it to Stacy Bowles. He's now third. Stacy been having some really good runs here in 2013. Got that 11B advanced transmission car hooked up, ready to go. Michael Chilton making noise on Ryan Gifford for fourth. T-Mac, Tim McCready leads Dale McDowell, Stacy Bowles. Top three. Come down, 20 down, 20 to go, halfway right here. Chilton for fourth spot. He's trying to get around Ryan Gifford, the 97, his first ever trip here. The Central Painting Revolution race car. Michael Chilton, he wants fourth. Is Ryan Gifford gonna give it to him? What about Riley Hickman back there? Riley started at ninth. He wants in the top five here tonight. Greedy getting ready to get around the lap car of George Mashburn as the 61 entry pulls into the pits. Caleb Ashby, his night's over with. Lap car between first and second. Just over the halfway point in this one. It's been a doozy so far. Shane Clanton and Tim McCready battled it out there for several laps. McCready pulled in under caution, not sure what happened to his entry. T-Mac's up front. Daniel Miller pulls it into the pits, his night's done. Car ran over in turn number two. T-Mac, Tim McCready, the Sweeteners Plus Warrior Race Car for T-Mac out of Watertown, New York up front. Dale McDowell, Mac Daddy second. Ryan Gifford, Stacy Bowles, Michael Chilton. Here we go. Just 14 to go in this one, folks. It's going to be a dogfight to the finish. Gifford gets loose there off of two. Couple of them get together, Stacy Bowles. Three wide out of four. Gifford gonna hold the spot. Chilton trying to make it three wide. Here comes Riley Hickman behind him. And the F-26 has got a left rear flat, I believe, maybe. Flat tire for the F-26 car, Mark Fields. Another yellow flag for a left rear flat tire.
11 to go.
McCready brings them down. Green flag in the air. 11 circuits left here tonight. Tim McCready, Dale McDowell. His teammate Ryan Gifford back here in third, and it's Stacy Bowles and Michael Chilton, Paris Series regulars. Sixth is Riley Hickman. Seventh is the 13th of Scott Cook. Eighth, David Payne. Ninth, Jason Welshen, and Billy Ogle Jr. battling with him for that ninth spot. The F-26 pulls in. Mark Fields, just under 10 to go. Trying to gain on the points from Steve Casebolt with the 13 slows in turn number three, Scott Cook. Scott Cook slows out of turn number four. Shredded right rear. Starting to wind down. It'll be two to go this time by from the 39. Trying to make it the seventh different winner in seven races for Spring Nationals competition. He's a regular out on the World of Outlaws Late Model Series circuit. Out of Watertown, New York, in the Sweeteners Plus Warrior chassis. Out front, Tim McCready. Dale McDowell a close second back there in the Tim Dillon Race and Entry Masters Belt. As Tim McCready going to come down to collect his first Spring Nationals win. T-Mac gets it done tonight in Duck River. Second is McDowell. Third is Gifford. Fourth is Bowles. Fifth is Michael Chilton, the top five. And we're going to victory lane.
The driver from Watertown, New York, race fans. Put your hands together for T-Mac, Tim McCready. Redemption. A podium finish with the World of Outlaws a few weeks ago. Tough break here for Shane Clanton, but you was able to take the lead. You had a very fast race car. Congratulations on your victory here tonight.
Yeah, thanks. It was just we got lucky in lap traffic there. Shane kind of messed up and slid into Dale and cleaned Dale out of the way, and I didn't really have to race Dale. So, we'll take it. We got lucky, and then Shane had to flat. I thought we were as good as him. I don't know if we could have ever passed him, but it was fun racing.
I tell you what, you guys had a dogfight. It was anybody's race there at the Flagstaff for three or four laps. Seemed like you could about race anywhere on the racetrack. Was your car pretty good about everywhere?
Yeah, I mean, I felt good. I felt good in qualifying, just a little free, and we went to work and tightened up, and, you know, this place is a lot different than we were here a month or a couple weeks ago, so I like it more like this. It's a lot more fun, so I don't know. It's one of those nights I feel great. Pro Power Engine, Sweeteners Plus, and VP Rage Fuels, everybody helps us out. Tagger Shocks. We didn't crash, but we bent the car up at Southern Ohio last week and had to put a new rear end in, and spindles and lowers and uppers, so we didn't hit nothing. So it's nice to come to a track that's fairly smooth again. So thanks to the track management and Ray for putting this whole deal on.
Big win tonight. Congratulations. Enjoy it. T-Mac, Tim McCready. Second place, the driver, the Team Dillon Racing Master Spill, all smiles. He got the inaugural win on March 15th. Good run for MacDaddy Dale McDowell in second tonight.
It was. The racetrack was racy, and didn't want to see that caution. Got up on the outside of Timmy, and I think my car was pretty decent out there, and he moved up, you know, once he seen I was out there, and he was pretty good out there. So other than that, you know, we just tried the bottom there, but our tires started going away right there at the end, and so I was just trying to go where he wasn't, but it's fun. The racetrack was good. You know, it was good racing.
Good run for the 17M. Dale McDowell in second tonight. Third place, another good run for his teammate right there, Winchester, Tennessee's Ryan Gifford in third. Congratulations. Tell us about your run.
I was out there just trying to learn a little bit. You know, this is my first open motor race in probably a year and a half. So, I was thankful to get the pole and, glad to see Dale and I, you know, both ended up with a top three, so that was cool. I got to thank Shane and all the guys back there that, work on the car and work hard, and thank Team Dillon Racing for this opportunity. It was cool to get to come out here and race in front of all my hometown fans and friends, and hopefully get to come back soon.
Congratulations on your third-place run. We'll see you back.
Thank you.
All right, Ryan Gifford, driver in third spot.
They're cinched up, they're lined up, and they're racing. We're getting dirty at the duck. Kenny Kaiser, great break from the outside, takes the lead from Daniel Miller. Leads them through turn four on lap number one. Couple of cars sideways. Third Joey time. Tucker. Pure Pony, you should be lined up for your feature. Pure Pony, you should be lined up for your feature in the staging area. Here we go. On the break, Kaiser again getting a good hole shot. Miller slots into second. Gentry is third. Henry Hanger fourth. Matthew Summers up to fifth. Good run for him. Joey Tucker in sixth. No problem. Sorted out. We're ready to try it one more time. The green flag out once again from Vince Madden. He's getting a chance to wave that again and again tonight. Still no laps in the book. Daniel Miller kind of grateful for that restart single file. He's out in front. Kenny Kaiser in second. Henry Hanger in third, David Gentry fourth. Flat tire on the 29. Matthew Summers running in the fifth spot right where he started. Battle for the lead coming up. Kaiser getting a good run on the inside of Miller. Can't get the grip down there just yet. Front five static. Siebers runs in sixth. Tucker is seventh. Pat Kelly about to go a lap down. Battle for the lead really beginning to heat up out in front. Miller just barely hanging on to it right now. Battle now for third. Here comes Gentry taking a move on Hanger. Those two running on the bottom group side by side. Half distance, lots of lap traffic up ahead. Kaiser's got to be steeling himself for that one. Hanger and Gentry still going at it for third and fourth. Thornton and Golden having a good battle back there for seventh and eighth. Here it comes. Oh, Joey Tucker almost lost it right in front of the leaders. Here it comes. Here it comes. There it comes. Here comes the 22 on the inside. Not there. Lap traffic up in front. Five laps to go next time passed. Here comes Kaiser. Oh, cars cross up in front. That is going to cost him dearly. And the yellow flag, wow. That was pretty much the race. Handed to Daniel Miller. Kaiser's in fifth. We have six laps to go and a whale of a shootout coming. Gentry to the inside of Hanger trying to take over the third spot. Here comes Kaiser. Good bite off the inside. Gentry may have third. Slide job. Gentry into the third spot. Hanger fights back on the high side, can't get it done. Three laps to go this time. Lap traffic up ahead, the 0W. Pat Kelly and Gentry trying to get one more before it's over with. He is getting terrific grip on the inside. David Gentry closed his eyes, pointed the car, and there it went. But here's your winner, 16M, Daniel Miller. Kenny Kaiser hangs on for second over a charging David Gentry. Wow, Henry Hanger fourth. And a terrific job by Matthew Summers rounding out the top five.
16-22.
Vince Madden hoping it's going to be the last time he waves that green flag tonight. What a terrific night of racing it's been at the Duck. Non-stop action from beginning to end. Let's see how they're going to finish it. John Neal, Joshua Nichols, lead them down to it. Getting dirty. And around goes your pole sitter with a little bit of help. Cinched up, lined up, and back under green. They are breaking the laws of physics through the turns, three and four abreast. Somehow Freddie Smith comes out of this with third place. And Josh Nichols will lead the field around as they come die to complete lap number two. And yellow out. It is not Stegall. Nichols, Burns, and Smith, that's pretty much your outside row for the starting order. Oh, and some smoke out of your leader. Freddie Smith, big move on the outside, takes over second. Or does he? Three abreast for second, third, and fourth. Yellow out again for the 222 Paul Teachout down there in turn four. And just as things were starting to get interesting. Gonna try and bring them home for a dozen more. Green flag is out. The smoke may be getting just a little bit more noticeable on that nine. Here comes Burns, good look to the outside, and around go two cars in turn two.
Slow down, man.
Once more, green flag in the air. echelon formation off of turn two. Burns to the inside, looks for the lead. Around goes Wilson inside the tire. He's rolling again, but going to lose a lot of ground. Burns to second. Smith up to third, looking high. Good run for Pinkston. He's in fourth, looking for third. Smith bounces off the wall on the back straightaway. Pinkston to the inside of Smith, takes over third. That appears to be the 23. Getting ready to put paid to this one. Here we go again. Joshua Nichols leads them down. Paul Burns looked like he had his number just a few minutes ago. Pinkston may have the fastest car on the racetrack right now. The number 34 has been on a charge. Meanwhile, Tim Wilson has made his way back up. Here, gives Burns a little bit of a shot, gives them another one, and loses some ground as a result. Side by side for fourth. Freddie Smith gives Pinkston a shot, while the 14 heads to the infield. Have to correct myself there. That's Opie in the infield. Terry Brown now assumes the fifth place. Under fire from Tyler Kaysen. And what a start Chris Pinkston got, but into the wall! Into the wall! Burns and Pinkston hard into the turn two wall. Points leader Freddie Smith back on the racetrack, but I believe he's lost at least one and perhaps two laps. The points leader got back out onto the track and just as quickly shut it down and took it into the infield. We have five laps to go. Tim Wilson all over the back bumper of the nine of Joshua Nichols. Gavin Stegall holding on to third, only just. And here comes the battle for the lead. Stegall had been third, takes to the infield, has lost a lap. Here comes Wilson. Two laps to go. Down the back straightaway, they're going to be looking for the white flag. Nichols has led the entire race. Wilson looking to take it away at the last second. Wilson to the inside. Here comes the move. They touch. Door handle to door handle. Who's going to take it? Down the line, Joshua Nichols by about 3 feet. Great way to finish the night. Tim Wilson has to settle for second. And that will conclude the night's racing.